Hey there, folks. My name is Daizoren, and welcome back to Back to the Future, Episode 3. All right, so we got to do some more law breaking so that we can get Doc's attention. All right, Mom.
Mom?
Hi. Give me the flask.
Mom, look, I'm on your side. If you got a problem, I want to help, but this is a choice you got to make yourself.
Oh, look at you. You're such a sweet boy. I'm so glad you take after me rather than your father.
What, Lorraine? What?
Ugh, I can't live like this!
Dad, you're not helping.
Oh, but I disagree, Martin. It's important that I catch her in the act so I can get it on tape. Once it's on tape, I can show her that she has a problem.
That's
that
ridiculous,
makes
Dad.
No
you're
sense.
Acting like this is some kind of sting operation.
Huh? Where'd she go?
Mom?
Aha! I knew it! There! What did you just hide? That was some sort of fruity liqueur!
It's a spray bottle of simple orange for the cleaning I'm trying to do!
Oh boy.
Lorraine, I'm sorry. It's...
Mom?
Okay.
Mom, please.
Yeah, Lorraine, listen to us.
Oh, I'm not...
What? Butt out! Mom? Mom?
Huh? Where'd she...
Mom?
Hey, is that...
No!
Lorraine, don't ignore me! Lorraine!
How do I... If I go to the squawk box, it's somebody else.
What's the problem, citizen?
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, I'll have a double-double animal style.
That's it. It's called an emergency intercom for a reason. I'm wrapping you for an SCR 300. Take your demerit printout before you go.
Okay. What do I do? Stack of demerits. Show them to her? I don't know.
It's got my name on it. They couldn't do anything with this.
Okay, then. But this one?
It's got my...
Okay, then. Hey, Mom, I'll play some guitar for you.
Only I could tame this beast of...
Okay.
Mom?
Let me see here.
Is it...
I got caught making out.
Mom, I got into some trouble.
Did you walk on the grass again?
No, Jennifer and I got caught making out.
Martin!
I know, Mom, but I
you
had...
You two are back together? How wonderful! That just lifts my heart.
Sorry, my light was all messed up. Okay, well, all right.
I can't take this.
Being so perfect must take a lot out of you.
But... I don't know. Okay, so let's see here. The statue. Really?
Mom?
Wait. Is that what I'm supposed to do to, like, get it out of the way of the
Mom,
camera?
Please.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Hang on. Okay. I got the idea here.
No.
All right. Hit it again.
What happened? What
yeah.
What am I looking at?
There
yes.
we go. Okay. Where'd she go? There she is. All right.
Mom, now that Dad isn't watching.
Oh, Martin.
Was that a flask, Mom?
Flask? Don't be ridiculous. I...
Look, it's okay, Mom. Get a hold of yourself.
Oh, your father's right. I'm backsliding. But it's been so hard.
No, it's
your brother and sister leaving, and then your father getting obsessed with his monitors and...
Oh.
Let me take care of the flask. Dad doesn't have to know anything about it.
Aww.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. I couldn't bear the thought of facing your father over this.
All right. Get that flask.
This timeline sucks. Mom and Dad are fighting again. Mom's drinking. It's like everything Doc and I ever did to fix things is falling apart. Time to get some attention.
All right. Where do I want to use this? Right in front of Parker?
Hands up, citizen. Assume the position.
Here goes nothing.
There better be apple juice in this.
Nope.
Why don't you open it and find out?
Don't get smart with me. I knew you were no good, McFly.
Officer Parker, what seems to be the problem here?
Citizen McFly, ma'am. Came strolling up with a 181B violation in his pocket.
Ugh.
Yeah.
You, young citizen, where did you get that? That booze?
Nowhere?
Is he being smart with me?
Yeah, he played that attitude on me as well.
Can we just fast forward the lecture and just get this over with already?
No!
Officer, demerit him severely. And as for the alcohol, drop it into the recycling bin.
With pleasure, ma'am.
Okay, so we're getting there. Is it time yet?
Now, keep your nose clean, or you'll find yourself in front of Citizen Brown.
Perfect. Okay, so making friends with a stray dog. So I gotta find Einstein. Where is Einy? I know I saw him. He was like around something like this. Where was he? Einstein. Einy. Was he back? Was he back over by the house? I know I saw him. Maybe he's back in the backyard, if I can go back there? I don't know. Let's find out, shall we? Can we? No, we can't. Okay. What do we got here? So look for last dog in the valley. You need something to lure him out of hiding. What do I have in my inventory? I have Doc's notebook. Which would obviously probably have the scent of Doc in it. Okay. All right. Let's get back in the car. Where? All right. I have Doc's notebook. Can I use it on something? Come on. There's gotta be something I can use this on. Can't. No. Can't stop. Won't stop. Addicted to this new shindig. Tried once. Says gonna win big. I don't know. Where am I supposed to go to find Einy? Wait a minute. There's a plank here. I never saw that before.
I don't want to go digging through the trash unless I absolutely have to.
Well, no. Climb it.
It's better if I keep this on me.
Yeah. Climb through there. There's only one place in town vending any kind of food. The soup kitchen, right? Okay, well, let me go talk to Leech. Free soy dog samples. Ah, okay.
McFly, you're a real buzzkill, you know that?
Free samples?
Where are the free samples?
Here, I keep them behind the counter.
Thanks. Don't eat it.
Oh, God.
If you puke, you're cleaning it up, wuss.
I can't finish this.
Not my problem.
Okay, so now that I have that. Never mind.
See ya.
Smell you later.
Okay, so now.
Even screwed up Nutso Hill Valley doesn't deserve that smell.
Okay, so now that I have. Yeah!
Hey,
Einstein!
Hey, there's that mangy. Go get him, McFly!
Yeah, I'll go get him. No problem. He went through, yeah, through the plank. Einstein. Okay, pick up. No, not the ammo box. Take that. Sorry, Jennifer. Gonna need that, though. Apparently. I don't know what for, but I'm gonna need it. Einstein!
He's gotta be hiding in here somewhere.
Einy.
Decency prevents me from leaving this here. Stay put now, boy. Wherever you are.
Einstein!
Not a sign of him.
No! He left again. Damn it. Okay, so I know where he was now.
McFly? My spray can?
Oh.
Sorry.
Dork.
Oof. Okay. Einy. There he goes. No, Dude! Stop it! Go back! Go after Einy! Alright, so now that we know which way he goes in... Okay. Alright.
Where could he be hiding?
Grab this. Behind the pallet?
Decency prevents me from leaving this here.
No.
Decency prevents me from leaving this
here. Okay, fine. Pallet.
You in there, Einy? Or whatever your name is these days?
Really?
Not a sign of him.
Okay, so can I go back in there?
I don't want to go digging through the trash unless I absolutely have to.
Okay, so I can't do... Oh, I wonder... I got an idea. Okay, so run out here. Right. Einstein runs back. We have to run back out. Walk back out and then walk back in. Okay. I think I have an idea. Grab this. Yeah. Take that. Don't think I need to use it on this, but.
It would look better blue.
Okay. Oh, I get it. I get it now. Okay. So we gotta lure him out again. And this will allow him to get paint on him.
Where could he be hiding?
Okay, pallet, just check that.
Stay put now, boy.
Alright. Okay, run out here. Or walk out here real quick. Yeah. Come on, skip! I wanna skip this. Okay. Walk back out. Yep. Come on. All right. Go back in. Aha! Yes. Gotcha, boy. There should be blueprints now. Going exactly to...
Now we're in business.
Yeah.
Decency prevents me from leaving this here.
Fine.
I outsmarted you, didn't I? Oh, whoa. Don't be like that, Einy.
Here. Hot dog sample.
Look, Einy, I've got a treat for you. Atta boy, now hold still.
There you go,
see,
Einstein.
You're not such a bad guy, right? Whoa, okay. Guess I've won you over. I wish they were all this easy.
Yeah. Alright, come on, Einstein. Yay!
Huh? What is it, boy?
Edna.
Einstein, wait! No!
Go, Einstein, go!
Radies, help!
Back! Down! Sit! Play dead!
Officer Parker, subdue that beast at once!
Einstein, sit!
Einstein?
Oh, if he bites me, you'll be in a world of trouble, citizen.
He doesn't like you.
Wait, I know that creature. Officer Parker, that's the stray that keeps escaping the kennel. I thought he was muzzled.
I took the muzzle off.
You what?
That's right, he's my dog now.
Citizen, you're in violation of statute 357K.
Aww.
Parker,
Rainy.
Demerit this hooligan at once. I'll return this creature to the kennel.
Yes, ma'am.
Filthy, wretched beasts.
Don't worry, Einy. Once I fix all this, you'll be back with Doc and romping through time.
Now stay out of trouble, unless you want a visit from Citizen Brown.
I do. Come on. What else do I gotta do?
McFly.
What, Jennifer?
Hey, Jennifer. Are you still angry with me?
Angry? Nah. The threatening Citizen Plust was worth it just to see my dad's veins go all purple like that.
Great. Because I gotta go.
Jeez, Martin, what's gotten into you? Booze, dogs, necking in public? It's like you're a different guy today. A way cooler guy.
I know this is gonna be hard to believe, but I'm the same guy I've always been. It's everyone else who's messed up.
Her arms are like floating.
Stop calling me Martin. It's Marty.
Well, Marty, what's next on the agenda? Knocking over banks?
Maybe. What's a guy gotta do to get in trouble around here?
I think you're about to find out.
You, citizen.
All right.
Here, Jen.
Not a problem.
Are you Martin Seamus McFly?
Seamus?
Yes.
We have a warrant for your detention.
Detention?
You've accrued over 15,000 demerits in the past 24 hours.
15,000?
Young Mr. McFly is being branded as a criminal of weak moral character. Cool.
I'm not weak.
But you are in a heap of trouble.
Trouble?
Oh my, yes. But don't worry, we're here to take care of you.
Like your Citizen Plus program took care of Biff?
Perhaps. The program is in need of new volunteers. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. First, let's see what Citizen Brown has to say about your particular strain of antisocial behavior.
You're taking me to Citizen Brown?
Immediately.
Awesome.
Officers, away with him.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, let's go.
It's about time.
I always knew your goody-two-shoes A-plus student act was too good to be true.
All right, let's go see Doc. This is going to be interesting. Heine. All right, it's time to convince Doc that we got to change things.
Come in, citizen. Martin McFly, age 18, resident of Sector L, Father George, Mother Lorraine, president of the Junior Brown Brigade, recipient of a full ride scholarship to Strickland College, winner of the Courthouse Challenge Deportment Award, zero demerits until this morning. The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Huh. It was the only way to see you.
Gotta believe me, Doc. I only did it to get your attention.
Doc, interesting. You regard me as a doctor, indicating awareness that you're suffering from some variety of mental disorder. That's a hopeful sign, Martin. Of course, I'm not actually a doctor, but I do have the tools to turn you around and put you back on the road to societal normalization. Shall we begin with a few questions to establish a baseline?
Sure.
Whatever. Let's get through this nonsense so I can set you straight.
You'll set me straight? Explain.
Whoa, what was that?
This, what you've turned into, it's all wrong. You're supposed to be a scientist, an inventor. You created the flux capacitor, and we went on all these crazy adventures in time, and your hair, you don't look good, Doc.
So you believe this interview is really more about me than you?
Yes.
You went through all this trouble just to deliver a message to me in person?
Yes.
A cry for help, as it were.
Yes. No way.
Tell me, Martin, is your mother on the sauce again?
Really? Not where I'm from.
Not where I come from. When I left here, both my parents were happy and well-adjusted. Okay, they didn't start out that way, but that's where your time machine comes in.
Time machine?
Yeah, Doc, listen to me. You don't remember it, but you built a time machine out of a DeLorean.
Why?
Why not?
Well, just for the hell of it, I guess. Plus, the steel frame of the DeLorean, dispersal, I don't know. It was important for some reason.
Fascinating.
Yes,
give him,
yes, it is fascinating. It's,
give him his
it's
book.
Amazing. It's incredible. But you don't know it because you've never invented it. You're not the real Doc Brown. You gotta believe me.
And this is because?
Everything got screwed up when I went back in time to 1931.
Sounds like this time machine is a very impractical and dangerous invention.
No.
Yes, I mean, no. What I mean is it's messed up a lot of things, but first, it made a lot of things better. Like my mom and my dad. It was only thanks to your time machine that they ever became successful and
come
happy.
On.
So they're happy.
But they're not, because you summoned me back in time, and somehow your timeline got messed up, and everybody else is along with it.
Come on.
I see.
No, you don't. Think. Show think back. Don't him. You remember me? We knew each other when you were 18. I'm Michael Corleone.
Incredible. This case is more serious than I'd imagined. The boy has fabricated an alternate reality.
Show him. I wish it were
Believe
that simple.
Me, I wish I had fabricated it.
Calm down, Martin. I'm not blaming you for anything. The failure is ours, not yours. Obviously, there was a drastic flaw in your social conditioning.
Yeah, I don't understand.
No, I don't understand yet, but I want to. I want to get at the root of your problem.
We have his notebook.
Take your time. Look around the room. Perhaps something here
show
will stimulate
him
your
the notebook.
Your memory.
Okay, notebook. First thing I'm doing right here. Doc's notebook.
Check this out, Doc. It's all your notes about the flux capacitor, your greatest invention.
That can't be my notebook. The handwriting is far too sloppy.
Really?
Okay, take a look at this picture of Einstein here.
The dog. Harboring dangerous animals is a municipal offense.
Yeah, they told me. But you harbored this very same animal once, a long time ago. Remember the test run of your rocket car? Einstein landed on the roof of the courthouse.
I do recall something of the sort, but naturally it couldn't have been the same dog.
There wasn't anything natural about it. Einstein's a time traveler too, thanks to your invention.
An impressively detailed illusion. Keep talking.
Okay. Symbol.
I can't tell if it's a guy celebrating a touchdown or chained up in a gulag. Glass half full, Marty. Half full.
Okay. Aha!
So that's what Judge Brown looked like. I never actually saw him.
Of course not. He died before you were born. He was my biggest supporter. After my wife, of course.
That's a switch. Last time I saw your younger self, you and your dad had just had a big falling out over your decision to become an inventor instead of a lawyer. Isn't that right?
Bizarre fantasy life. Go on. Proceed.
The clock.
Something about that clock looks familiar.
Hang on.
It's better if I keep this on me at all times.
Okay, fine, never mind. Something about that clock that's familiar. Okay. Fish tank.
Hey, this is your fish tank.
Yes, that is my fish tank.
It looks much better without all the bacteria.
What? Edna just had it cleaned.
Yeah, but in 1931 it was full of bacteria that we used to make rocket fuel. Remember?
Stop trying to confuse me! My whole life has been dedicated to the practical use of technology to shape a more efficient, orderly society. Ask anyone. It's a fact. Go look it up.
But you know better, right, Emmett?
Wrong. Do you see this picture?
Yes.
I keep it close by me to remind me of the moment when my life's course became clear. August 25th, 1931. The day I single-handedly captured Kit Tannen. The scourge of Hill Valley.
Single-handedly?
Doc, look at the picture. We're in it.
My scientific muse and the love of my life. Take a look. What do you see there is a young man who understands his destiny.
That's not what I see.
What do you see?
Okay, I'm like, okay.
Could that be? I think it is.
What?
It's me, and you, the other you.
It is me, and you.
Yeah.
How?
Time traveler.
Michael? It's impossible.
No, it's science. Yes. Your science, Doc.
In this other world, the one you say you come from, am I happy there?
Oh,
very
yeah.
Very happy. You've got two great sons.
Sons?
Yes, and a
Jules
fantastic
and Vern.
Wife.
Not
Clara.
Not even remotely. And your invention. Jeez, Doc, you can go anywhere you want to. Anywhere in time. You're the luckiest guy in the universe.
And what about Hill Valley?
Hill Valley? You know it's got problems. A little bit of urban decay here, a little bit of crime there. It's a normal city. People are happy, mostly. And even when they're miserable, they're not miserable like they are in your Hill Valley.
Stop! There are no miserable people in my Hill Valley.
Give me a break. You don't really believe.
My citizens lead lives of order and peace.
Nobody
worries. Nobody complains.
Only because they were afraid to. Jeez, open your eyes, will you? You and Edna have got him all terrorized.
That's Mrs. Brown to you, sonny.
Doc.
Kindly address me as your honor.
Okay.
We worked for over 50 years, my wife and I. Every waking moment devoted to ridding Hill Valley of vice and disorder. And you dare to claim that our citizens are unhappy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I do. I've seen it. They're just too afraid to speak up.
Afraid? Afraid of what?
Afraid of the consequences of their actions, Doc. You run this place like it's a police state.
Nonsense.
I can prove it.
Yeah.
All right then, time travel boy. You do that. And until you do, I'm going to treat your wild story as just that. A story told by a madman. And I've determined that the best treatment is simply to let the insanity run its course.
Okay then. I
so,
guess.
Is the interview over? Should I leave?
Please do. I'm very busy. I've got a city to run.
Okay, then.
Fine, but I'll be back with proof.
Uh-oh. Edna's gonna ruin the proof. Edna's gonna go and talk to George before I get there. All right. George.
Doc wants proof that Hill Valley isn't the perfect place he thinks it is. One smoking gun coming up. Death!
Oh.
About the tape, son. I think it's done rewinding. Oh.
Whoa, take it easy. Sit here.
Guess I blacked out for a minute there. Fell out of my chair.
Fell nothing. Somebody whacked you.
Whacked me? Impossible. We take great pride in the fact that incidences of physical violence in Hill Valley have fallen to virtually...
Who did it? Can you tell me?
This can't be happening.
There's gotta be a clue around here somewhere.
Okay, then. The baseball bat?
Dad, that's not one of our bats, is it?
No. No. McFlys never use aluminum bats. Curious.
Tannen?
Oh, wait, don't touch it. It's evidence.
Of what? Oh, why would anyone do a thing like that to a nice Sector L citizen like me?
to get to your tapes.
What's the last thing you remember? I was sitting right here, copying another incriminating scene onto my tapes. My tapes! What happened to my tapes?
Stay calm, Dad.
Are they on the floor? Do you see them? They're in a box marked raw footage.
Nope, they're all gone. It is all gone. Wait, I saw it. It's a tape case. Where was it? I saw it. I saw it. Where was it? Well, I just saw. There it is. Wait. Where? Tape case. Jeez.
Here it is. Raw footage.
Thank heavens.
All gone.
Wait a minute. You see, I told you were just jumping to conclusions. All these dark suspicions about thieves and attackers went all the time. It was just
empty.
What? There's no tapes.
Yeah, they're
I'm
all gone.
I'm sure they were in there before.
Before whoever it was whacked you in the head and took them.
Oh my gosh, I've been mugged. Mugged in Hill Valley. They can't get away with it. Oh!
Don't worry, Dad. We'll get to the bottom of this.
Who could have done this to me?
Edna.
Who wouldn't want Doc to get the straight dope on Hill Valley? Edna!
Are you saying I was mugged by the mayor's elderly wife?
No, but somebody
not exactly
hired
no.
by her.
Oh, it's no use. The tapes are gone. All I can do is hope against hope they don't surface and land me in trouble.
Come on, Dad. We can't just give up.
Okay, start grilling people. Let's look for more clues.
I mean, maybe there's some more clues around here.
What's the use? Even if we find out who took the tapes, we're not going to be able to get them back without attracting attention to ourselves.
There's got to be something we could do to get our hands on those tapes.
Well, all right.
We can make new ones.
We can?
Sure. It may take a while, but if you're willing to help your old man out, it shouldn't take us more than, say, 6 months.
6 months? But I need those tapes now.
You need the tapes.
What I mean is...
I'm worried for your safety.
And what if this mugger comes back? Another bang on the head might do you in.
You said you needed the tapes.
I need to give it to Citizen.
I gotta give it to Citizen Brown. I told him I was gonna furnish him with proof that Hill Valley isn't as happy as he thinks it is. And I was in his office just before I came here.
You had an interview with Citizen Brown?
It wasn't easy to get, believe me. I had to break all kinds of rules.
You've been breaking rules?
Harboring stray dogs, kissing girls in public, getting caught with Mom's flask.
That is the most far-fetched story I've ever heard.
Well,
it's true.
Too bad.
You forget I'm your father. I know your history.
Yeah, well, history's changed.
Prove it.
Okay. All of these.
Read them and weep.
Demerits, but...
It was the only way.
I don't understand.
Dad, listen to me. I mean, really listen. You and I both know that things aren't right here. Citizen Brown might have started with good intentions, but his Hill Valley's just made everybody miserable.
Shh! You said that to him?
Basically, yeah.
Oh, there go our privileges.
No, wait, I got him to listen, Dad, and he's gonna make things right for you and Mom and all of us. I can't
if
explain how.
We can prove it.
You're just gonna have to trust me on this.
Okay.
But first I have to show him your tapes to prove my point.
Oh, no.
Dad.
This scheme of yours. Maybe you know what you're doing. I can't say. But leave me out of
Dad.
It. I don't like trouble. I can't handle it. It's not in my genes.
But...
Do it for Arthur.
Do it for your father.
My father?
Yeah, Arthur McFly.
I know his name.
Didn't he have something to do with putting away Kid Tannen, you know, way back when?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, he did. Where do you hear about that?
I know.
It was way back before Citizen Brown cleaned up the town, before I was even born.
Yeah.
Everyone lived in terror of Kid Tannen and his goons. But Dad stood up to him.
Yeah.
He had evidence of Kid's guilt, see, and he risked his life to deliver it to the authorities. Never be afraid to do the right thing. That's what he always used to tell me.
And what are you doing?
Trying to remember which is the right feed.
Feed to what?
To the surveillance camera, the one in the yard.
Wait a minute. You have a surveillance camera trained on yourself?
Of course. Gotta cover all bases. Now help me figure out which monitor I'm on.
Okay, we're gonna pause it here. So we're gonna save the game, and that's gonna do it for this episode. We're making some serious progress, which is great. So anyway, that's gonna do it for this episode, so thank you all so much for watching. You guys made this channel happen, and I thank you very much for that. And I will catch you in the next video.